Hello, in this video we're going to show you how to transfer TexturingXYZ skin micro details onto your custom character. As you may know, TexturingXYZ's VFace is a huge collection of super high quality and high resolution skin micro detail maps. Each pack includes a set of maps like albedo, cavity, displacement maps, normal maps, etc. TexturingXYZ's maps are stored in 16 and 32 bit format. We can now do the entire texture transfer pipeline inside Wrap since it supports high bit textures. So, suppose we have our character here and we want to bring in texture details for this character. We can go to the TexturingXYZ website and look for a texture pack that suits our character the best. In this case, I'm going to use this texture pack. All the maps in VFace correspond to one common base mesh, which is available for download from the TexturingXYZ website here. Adding micro details to your character is as simple as wrapping the base mesh onto your model. Thanks to TexturingXYZ, from now on, in the latest versions of Wrap, the TexturingXYZ base mesh comes included in the Wrap standard gallery, and you can find it in the TexturingXYZ section. So to simplify things, we have created a special project for you that you can find under the TexturingXYZ section of the gallery. So let's load this project. All you need to do in this project is to click here and select file path to your character mesh. In this case, I'm going to use this mesh. If you go to viewport 2D, you can see that our character has three UDIMs. In your case, it may be a different number of UDIMs, starting from 1 and up to 1000. What we need to do next is go to File, then Edit Project Script. Or alternately, you can press Ctrl-I. Here you will see a global Python script. But don't worry, all you need to know about this is that you need to change this number to the number of UDIMs that your character has. In this case, I'm going to input 3 and click Accept. Then here in this node, you need to select all the TexturingXYZ maps from your pack that you want to transfer. So I go to the head folder, then maps, and here I select all 6 EXR maps that come with this pack, and I click open. Here we already have the TexturingXYZ base mesh loaded, and all we need to do now is to wrap this base mesh onto our character model. To do that, I'm going to use a fast wrapping node. So all I need to do is to click compute, and it will automatically wrap the TexturingXYZ base mesh to my character. To make this work more precisely, you may want to provide a set of point correspondences, or you may also want to provide a set of polygon selections to exclude the mouth socket and eye sockets if needed. But in this case, let's assume that the result is good enough for our purposes. After wrapping, you can also go to the brush node and quickly make corrections to your model. But in this case, let's leave it like it is and click accept. Then what we need to do is go to the transfer texture node, and it already has transferred the textures to our character. All we need to do is to increase the resolution of the transfer to whatever you would like to use. In this case, I'm going to use 4096 by 4096. Alright, the next node will basically fill the empty areas between the texture islands with the extrapolated color. Like that. And now, as I'm switching to the next frame, it's going to project my UDIM number 2, then UDIM number 3, and it's going to switch to the next texture, and again, it projects UDIM number 1, UDIM number 2, and UDIM number 3. And then we go to the next texture, and so on. So now what I'm going to do is just go over here to the Save Image node, and just click the Compute Frame Range button. I'll set the number of processors to something like 4. It depends on how powerful your machine is. And now I just click Start. The processing will take some time to project all the textures. So let me speed up the video and come back to you when the processing is finished. Alright, the processor's finished with the following error. Since we only have 3 UDIMs and 6 textures, we only need to project 18 textures. But on our timeline, we have 25 frames, so it basically doesn't have more data to process. but that's okay, we can close this window. And now all our textures have been saved to the original TexturingXYZ folder. If we go to our original maps folder, we can see a new folder called Export. If we open it, we can see that our 18 maps have been transferred with just a few button clicks in just a few minutes. And if you go here and bring in all those maps, you can see that all of the maps were transferred correctly. So this is how you can transfer details to your characters within minutes. And since all the TexturingXYZ maps correspond to one common base mesh, now with this done, you can basically select any other set of maps from TexturingXYZ, for example, the ID maps here. And we can transfer them as well, just by clicking the Compute Frame Range button. Let me speed up the video here. And we can also go and select another character. In this case, I'm going to this new pack and will select all these textures. And again, I can just process all those textures by simply clicking the Compute Frame Range button and hitting Start. So, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like it. See you in the next video.